This is a 2021 vibe. This is saving coins. Can you tell that I'm wearing different makeup on each side of my face? Is it that big of a difference? You let me know. That should be a resolution for everyone this year. I know we've spoken about resolutions already, but why spend extra if you don't need to? If you guys are also about saving that extra coin this year, drop this emoji, the money bag emoji, down below to tell me y'all about it. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we got Dupes Boo and the Realty. We're gonna be saving a third of the cost of the high-end side of our face. So on one side, as I've done before, if you haven't seen my first dupes video, go ahead, check it out. It'll be in the cards. I do one side with our high-end makeup and it will be totaling close to $300, while our affordable drugstore dupe side will be closer to $90. So if you're excited, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, like it, support the channel, I appreciate it. And let's get started with our makeup girl, because I'm ready to save the coins, and I hope you are too. Today's video is in partnership with Collab Makeup. You guys know, and if you don't, I'll say it again for the thousandth time. I'm one of the 8 members of the Collab Collective, which is a group of influencers that help guide the brand's direction and develop products. So I've been a part of this group, collective, whatever you want to call us, for, I want to say, 4 years now. It's been quite a bit, and in this video I will be showing you some fabulous dupes from the brand that will save you quite a bit of coin. I have a powder dupe, a concealer dupe, and a lip dupe. Just wait till you see what the high-end difference is. And if you're interested in any of their dupes, they are exclusively available at Sally Beauty, so very accessible in your local stores, or you can shop them on sallybeauty.com online. The links will be down below. I'm gonna go in my natural order of operations, because if I don't, I will probably end up a hot mess, even though these products are hot fire. So first things first is a skincare dupe. The serums we're gonna be speaking about are fairly newer, one very new, which would be the Glow Recipe Niacinamide Watermelon Glow Dew Drops. She released less than 2 months ago and she retails for $34. I do have a promo code for Glow Recipe, which you can find down below. It's for 15% off, but I'm just talking about full price, no discounts. On the affordable side, we have Glow Molecule, which is a skincare line by Beautylish. They're very affordable. They fall in line with, I never say it right, Inkey List and The Ordinary. This is a $6 niacinamide serum. I'm gonna say it differently probably every 4 seconds. Niacinamide. So there's a $28 difference between the two, but there are a few differences as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply just a little bit. I already have some on my face because I couldn't stand not having it hydrated before sitting down. Like, I don't want my face to start drying out on me. The Good Molecule side is a little less tacky. The Glow Recipes is very much so the tackiest, can we call it N serum, so I don't have to say it 7,000 times, N serum that I've ever used. I've used The Ordinary's, I've used other brands, and with this ingredient, it does take a couple weeks to see results, but it's a very popular ingredient for pore care, and overall it helps with breakouts because of its ability to help with texture and pores. So the Glow Recipe side has the signature watermelon scent that you see in their sleeping mask, their pink juice moisturizer, and this dries down faster, in my opinion, than any other one, but it does give you that milk makeup grip primer feel. This does, like I mentioned, have a fragrance, but the Good Molecule one does not. So if fragrance bothers you at all skin-wise, then you might really like this. Of course, there's The Ordinary's version too, but everyone knows about that, and I thought I'd bring attention to something that's even more affordable than The Ordinary's, just by very little bit, if you haven't checked it out before. They have a bunch of different things within their line, and I saw a lot of these dupes on Instagram as far as, like, what do you guys think? Like, do these, da da da. So I wanted to test it out side by side. I think the Glow Recipe is gonna give you more glow. Like, that's what the formulation is supposed to do, but you don't not look glowy on this side. You just have a different intensity, if you know what I mean. One, of course, has a pump, while the other one has a dropper. So it really just depends on what you prefer. Most of the time, I see it with a dropper. So personally, I like a really intense glow. So if I had to choose, I would say I'd still kind of lean Glow Recipe on this, but this is not like a review versus that intensely. This is just giving you guys options if you want to save coin, if you're, you know, starting your 2021 budgets and you're like, well, I want to, you know, cut down here and there. This might help. That's the whole point of the video. Next, we have brows. We're gonna glue them up. This is the NYX Brow Glue. You've seen it in my recent videos. It's $8. She's new. She's released. She's kind of tiny. She comes with 5 grams of product. 0.17 ounces, while on the other side, we have the very, very popular, infamous Benefit 24-hour brow setter that comes with a wand as well, a larger wand than the NYX one, as you will see, and this comes with 0.23 fluid ounces, so a little bit more product, but she retails for $24. We got 24 versus 8. As you can see, my brows are not done yet, so we're gonna try on both sides. I already know how the brow glue works, and I've tried the Benefit so many times, but I haven't tried it with a brow lamination, I don't think, which makes your brows a lot more bendy, shall I say, because it's like a perm for your brows. So if your brows are stubborn and point down, for me, they're a little more flexible. Like, they still can point down, but they'll move and stick a little easier. And though I'm typically just a soap gal, this is becoming way more popular now to produce a product that really helps slick the hairs back. The wand on the NYX brow glue is really, 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 really tiny. Like, lower lash line mascara, tiny. The one bad thing about the packaging is that I think eventually you're gonna have excess product stuck in it. I mean, that's safe to say the same thing about the Benefit side, but with such a tiny amount, I really wish you could get every last little drop. Of course, you could cut it open easier on the NYX side. And for Benefits, it's less sticky out of the tube. It feels more liquidy than gel right away. The brush is a plastic brush compared to the hair bristles on the NYX side. And it's more of a comb. It's not wrapping my hairs as easy. I gotta push down quite a bit because I have like really, you know, stubborn, tiny, whack hairs. But I have a feeling this one's gonna give us a better finish. A lot of people love this product. It's been, I think, possibly the favorite product out of the Benefit line. And I was really loving their brow pencils when they first came out. I feel like it's been a couple years too. NYX's looks a little more shiny. It's definitely more tacky as well. It's not the tackiest thing, but you can feel it, while the Benefits you don't feel. So if you were not wearing makeup, you'd probably find this way more comfortable. They both seem to be doing a good job holding up the inner corners all the way to the ends. I don't know how long this will last me on the side. I did push up each side. This has like a natural hair finish compared to the side where you're like, oh, there's definitely product there. But hopefully it lasts throughout the video. If it falls, we'll talk about it. NYX recently released a new brow product called the Lift and Snatch. I'm sure you've seen the videos on TikTok or Instagram. If you haven't, then I guess we're gonna learn about it together. This retails for $11 and I have the shade Caramel. Caramel? Caramel. I say both. What do you say? Let me know down below. And on this side, the very, very popular, possibly one of the first on the market, been around for a while, been around the block, she's the Glossier Boy Brow. And I have this in shade Brown, $11 versus $18. So that's not a huge difference, I know, but saving coin, especially depending on how fast you go through this and the accessibility of it. You can get NYX at so many different stores, while Glossier, you either have to order online or go to one of their stores or retailers. Naturally, side by side, they have the similar, it's not the exact same, similar components, while the NYX's tip is shorter than the Glossier by like a third. You can see the Glossier's is wider as well. And they both have shakers. I personally prefer a smaller brush because I feel like you can get more detail and thinner strokes, and that's what I want. This is my first time trying this product at all. The shade's definitely a warmer brown. You can see it. You can also blend this in with a little bit of a spoolie afterwards. My brow hairs are naturally, of course, black, but I like to use a brown. This is a lot warmer than expected, but sometimes if I get this product in too cool of a brown, it looks very Sharpie like. So we'll blend it in, and after our makeup's done, it's way less noticeable because my hair is technically brown right now. It's just that it's pulled back from the face, so you really can't tell. So I will probably perfect it in a second. You can just see the strokes. We'll blend it in. We'll do the Glossier side. On this brow, my inner corner is my main area of concern, and on this brow, my arch, the top of my arch, is my main area of concern, just because I have more hair on each area on the other brow. It's weird. Is it weird? It's just annoying. That's the word. Probably very normal. We all have a brow we favor more. So the Glossier shade right now is proving my point, where it's that dark brown effect. It's like, it's really intense, you know? It seems really, really dark. So I'm gonna take a spoolie. You can't really brush too much because they're kind of set, and you can just hear it like kind of like scraping almost against plastic. but just enough to kind of just help whatever strokes we have kind of blend in a little bit better. I'm gonna conceal my brow area to prep my eyelids and I'll be right back. Okay, lids are ready. So let's talk about this eyeshadow dupe. I gotta zoom you guys out. We need some space. This is something I've been wanting to test out literally since last spring, so me on the late bus, but you have seen me use from time to time this palette from Melt Cosmetics. This is their 420 palette, and she's my only Melt Cosmetics product, but I really, really, really love their pigmentation. I'm very interested in trying more. I've heard so many good things. Their formula is beautiful. It blends beautifully. It's super intense. It's awesome. So I picked this up originally to do this video. It has a really nice like hologram that actually moves when you move it. The packaging is top tier. While I also have used from time to time a similar color schemed palette from Juvia's Place. It's called the Nomad palette and she retails for $15. Excuse the front, that's lash glue. I can't get it off. Things have happened. It's been used and loved. So off the bat, you can see some resemblance, some difference. This is more of a, you know, simple packaging because Juvia's Place is an affordable but very, very large panned eyeshadow palette type of brand. These are larger than your standard ones, like bigger than MAC. 15 versus 58. And I will talk about, you know, the reasoning between picking either or, but again, if you want to save the coin, there are 5 shades between the palettes that I feel like are very interchangeable. So I'm gonna put the swatches right here while giving you guys a little bit of application footage next to it while I speak about it, because I don't want this video to be super long. If I go through the whole eyeshadow tutorial, it's gonna be like cray cray. But let me just quickly throw on my makeup. I'm gonna do, of course, half and half, and then we'll talk about it. And we're back, looking done. I'm actually really happy with how our makeup came out. Really, really happy. So I used 3 of the shades out of the 5 I have for you guys, as far as, you know, matching, similar. You know, not all the shades are perfect, but I think this is enough where I feel comfortable that I would say it's at least like a 75% to 85% dupe. But some of them to me are like perfect. Perfecto. So we're gonna walk through what shades I am wearing. Obviously Melt is on this side with the high end, and you can see I'm wearing the yellow shade, which is called Wax on the inner corner, while Juvia's Place does not have names on their palette, but I am using the yellow right here as well. So the yellow shade is not perfect. This is not an identical, but I think they are interchangeable. As you can see when they're applied, they're a little bit more similar. I would say the Melt side is a little bit more vibrant by nature because the Juvia's Place side is not a full matte. So all the shades I'm using from Melt are matte, but this is the one Juvia's Place shade that is not matte that I feel like kind of matches. This has sparkle in it. You can't really see the sparkle when applied. That's why I find it interchangeable in my opinion. Pigmentation wise, usually for every 3 strokes of Juvia's Place, like 3 dips, 3 tap offs, I would use 2 from Melt. So Melt is definitely more pigmented, but not by an obscene amount or a huge difference. The next shade is a crease shade, which is full Melt in the Melt Cosmetics side. This kind of looks like the darker version of Blunt. So the shade from Juvia's Place kind of falls right in between both of those, but I feel like you could interchange it and it's not that big of a deal when applied compared to swatched or in the pan. So the Juvia's Place side is this warm orangey brown. It's generally orange, basically. I don't know where the brown came from. Orange. And as you can see in the swatches, basically that middle. Still vibrant. If anything, a little bit more orange than the other two, a little less brown, a little less earthy. Pigmentation, almost exactly the same. I think it's easier to go a little bit overdone with the Melt side, but that's with all of the shadows. And then the rest of the shades, the 2 I'm not wearing would be green shades. So I didn't think it would work. I mean, you could have done it for the lash line. I wish I could wear all of them for you guys, but I think it would kind of ruin the makeup if I was just slapping everything together where I would normally do. So we're talking about Dank and Chronic on the Melt side. So we have more of like a mossy green color, and she's deep. She's like the shade of the palette right here. And then Dank comes off a little taupey brown, with some green undertones. These have perfect matches in the Juvia's Place palette. Chronic definitely looks just like this corner shade, while Dank looks like this bottom corner shade. And as you can see in the swatches, girl, she's a match. She's absolutely a match. The last shade that I applied would be my lid shade, another perfect match. On the melt side, it is the shade Roll It, the darkest shade in the palette. And in Juvia's Place, we have it in the middle of the bottom row. Perfect tone match, abso-freaking-lutely. This lid shade is probably the one that gave me equal trouble on both sides because it goes on really pigmented, but it like naturally kind of starts losing pigment in some areas, so it's a little bit more see-through if you don't put a dark base underneath it. And I didn't put concealer underneath it or a dark base, so that's just kind of where it is, but I just didn't want to do anything extra. I wanted to show the shadows just straight up, aside from, you know, the concealer that's all over the lid, which is normally always there. So those, in my opinion, are the matches. And you let me know what you think as far as the side-by-side, like if you would consider them dupes or comparable. I definitely think they are. There could be just a little bit more blending right here. I actually should have done that before coming back on the camera. I also didn't want to mess with it too much. I put the lashes on and I was just feeling myself and I ran back to tell you guys about it. For the difference, in my opinion, totally worth it. Don't even hesitate. But if you are interested in melt, they have really, really great formulas, and I'm definitely diving deeper. So that easily is gonna be the longest section of the video for us because we're talking about so many different shades and so many different things. The next dupe would be the eyeliner I am wearing. So I use both of these products all the time, and I absolutely think they're interchangeable, and it would save you a lot of money if you are a fan of pencil liner, whether you use it on the top, bottom, waterline, lash line, whatever you wanna use it for. So I am wearing the brown shade from both of these products. I don't have application because it really isn't important. I just literally went across my lash line, but I will give you guys swatches. On the high end side, we have the Makeup Forever Aqua Resist Pencil Liners. And as the name says, they're basically waterproof pencil liners that dry down pretty fast. And if you want to smudge these, you got to be rocket fast, light speed fast, gotta go, I'm late fast, because they don't budge. But I do get a little bit of transfer from these on my inner corner. I get that with almost every liner, unfortunately. It's just like, it'll go right there, like right next to the yellow in my waterline when I place in my waterline. But for the most part, otherwise, it's pretty long wear, enough that I continue to use it. But I keep that in mind. If I don't want any transfer at all, I usually would have to like consciously work with a cotton pad or a Q-tip to try to avoid it in the beginning. Anyway, I have graphite and I have ebony. Ebony is the brown shade. And then on the drugstore side, these are by L'Oreal. These are their infallible liners. I have it in black and I have it in brown, just straight up. And these are $9. So 9 versus 22. 22 is a lot for a pencil liner. Abso-freaking-lutely. These are also waterproof long wear pencils. And these transfer just a little bit less on the inner corner than the other one. And I love them. I go through them very quickly. The main difference is this is a sharpening pencil, like you need to sharpen it. And I've definitely been too lazy to find my sharpener and like scratch the crap out of my eyes. Don't recommend, user error. While the Makeup Forever is a twist up from the bottom. So you do not need to sharpen them. Both of them are very, very creamy and very, very long wear. So in the swatches I give you guys, you can see the shades side by side. You got a brown, you got a black. They're great. And if you are looking for something, definitely go try the Infallible. I highly recommend it. Now it's time for our base. So I have a foundation dupe for you guys and I have a concealer dupe. So I saw a prompt on Instagram that said, is the Wet n Wild stick foundation a dupe for the Huda Beauty stick foundation? Let's see them side by side. These are both very, very good products. I love them both. Wet n Wild is $7 and I use shade Golden Honey. Is this actually, no. I don't think this is my shade. I think I use Golden Beige. Maybe I'm crazy. I don't know. Definitely reference my website because I don't think I've ever had an additional shade, but I feel like it usually looks more yellow than this. I just gotta know. I gotta look it up. Yeah, so I usually wear Golden Honey in the stick, Golden Beige in the liquid. So that was my confusing part, but this is the shade list on my website if you haven't seen it. Those are all my comparisons. SamRobinson.blog/shades in the info box. It's been a while since I wore this, but I'm just gonna assume that they don't have a golden beige and this is just the comparable item. I definitely have a review on it. It's just been a few years. It's looking a little lighter than I remember, but I might have been maybe lighter. I don't know.
strange.
This is more of a recent shade for me on the Huda Beauty side. So this is 310G Almoready, and she's my summer shade. So we about to look crazy. Oh my God, this is about to be a whole issue. I think it looks more intimidating before it's blended out. Both of these products are super creamy. I think because we have our serums on that have more of a tacky finish, it's taking just a little bit more effort to blend compared to not wearing those. But of course, it's the same thing like wearing a sticky primer. Yeah, I'm gonna look a little different. She's just a bit different on this stage. So now it's really amplifying that high-end side. Because I think I need a darker shade in this foundation if I was wearing it right now. But I don't need another one right now. Price-wise, they are a huge difference. Wet n Wild's is $7, while Huda Beauty's is $39. Huda's, of course, comes in more shades, so of course that does make up for the difference in a lot of ways. But both of them have the same amount of coverage, basically the same finish. They're not super dewy, but they're not super matte, and they're both super creamy. So if you're looking for something that's interchangeable, I highly recommend that if you find a shade in the Wet n Wild. So this has 12 grams, while this has 12.5 grams. Very similar in amount. Now for our first collab dupe. So the rest of the video is actually all collab dupes. So collab has this No Flaws Under Eye Concealer, and this is in shade Light Peach, and it comes with 6.5 grams of product. This is a glass container, while on this side, same thing, glass container, we have 7 grams, just 0.5 grams more, of the Too Faced Peach Concealer, and this is a matte instant concealer. I've talked about it before, I've tried it before, and this is in shade Honeycomb. They do have a few more shades. It is currently right now on sale at Sephora for $12 or $13, but typically retails for $22, and I'm not going off of sales. I don't know if they're discontinuing it, or I don't know if they are just, you know, doing a promo right now. I'm going off of retail, because I mean, Collab has sales too, where you can buy one and get 50% off on certain times of the year. So just retail wise, this is usually $10 and this is usually $22. So as you can see, the shades aren't exactly perfect, and the finishes are not identical to a T, but I would say 75%. So Too Faced is a little bit more matte, but the feel of them to the fingertip, almost exactly the same. Same thickness, same pigmentation, same density. And I'm gonna use that for my under eyes on both sides. I'm gonna be using our concealer brush. This is an angled brush from Collab. I'm just kind of stamping this on and blending. Usually concealers in a pot, they're a little thicker, so you can, you know, tread lightly with them. Make sure we get that really nice angle and then blend. I apply cream concealers a little different than liquid concealers because they don't move as much. Like after they're kind of on, they're kind of on, while liquid you could kind of spread out and, you know, adjust differently. You can see, wow, look at that. Whoa. But the peachy undertone really helps with, you know, counteracting any dark circles, because peach is just known to do that. So obviously on the peach side, they have different shades, but all of them have a peach undertone. The Honeycomb shade has a little bit more of a yellow, as you can see, a little bit. But it's actually pretty peachy compared to my other concealers. So we're gonna apply it the same way. If you're curious, I actually use this in between my eyeshadow shades. So I like to apply the eyeshadows in these videos with the same brush, but you can wipe this off. For concealers, I wipe it off on a tissue and just use the same brush. I do have a couple different like amounts of this brush because I really like it for my eyelids and my under eyes, but just so you guys know where my brain goes as far as accuracy. And you can't really tell the difference. Like, yes, this is a little bit dewier because this is supposed to be more matte, but if you're setting it, it really doesn't make a difference, and the amounts in the jar are almost the same. I feel like you need less of the Collab one, to be honest. So in my heart, it evens out. Let me know if you think it does down below. To set our under eyes today, I am, girl, I'm it. Y'all need to hear me for this one, so come on in. This is, of course, my favorite powder, and it's by Collab. I talk about it all the time. Set the Stage Soft Focus Powder. Perfect light banana yellow shade that's not too yellow, very fine, very glowy. It does have a really nice soft focus without being glittery. I think it's the perfect dupe for the KKW Beauty Bake and Brighten combo set. They have a system in KKW Beauty, if you're not familiar. It came out a while ago and I did review it. So the shade I'm gonna talk about in a second isn't exactly what I'd recommend now, but they have a system where you conceal with their concealer, you use the loose powder, and then you use the pressed powder, which is the extra like soft focus pop of it all. So honestly, I'm really comparing this to this for effect, but I did bring out the loose powder because this also is more similar of a product and it aids in that brightening. So whether you get one or two, like if you needed both of these for 18 each, that'd be 36 versus the collab price. But let's just talk individually. Let's do 18 versus 15. It's not the biggest difference, I'm aware, because this is $14.99. But now hear me out. Collab comes with 10 grams of product, while KKW Beauty's comes with 3.5. That's like three times more for $3 less. To me, it's painfully obvious, but I feel like I have to justify it, that this is the better deal and absolutely a great dupe for it. So this is primarily the shade that this powder is offered in on the Collab side, while KKW Beauty has different shades. This is shade number 2 in both, which is definitely not the shade I recommend anymore. They have shade number 3, which is more yellow, which is more of a perfect match or similar match color family to this shade, but I don't own those. So we're gonna work with what we have. This is pinkier, and this is what I originally got because it was what was recommended for like my concealer, like what was really gonna give you that dramatic pop. So we're gonna apply those, dipping into the loose powder. I don't really like to bake with all these things. I'm gonna bring it around my nose. I'm gonna blend everything in. I didn't end up contouring with cream contour, so I'm not gonna do like the line and the bake right there, but I will put a little bit on a piece of my chin. It's already on this side, and a little bit right here on this brow corner. I feel like really helps brighten. Of course, we're gonna use like a powder bronzer all over later just to complete the look. Moving on to KKW Beauty. Both of these powders are really, really fine. I'm gonna have to do another baby dip. And same thing for our chin and above our eyebrow. You can really see the difference here because my foundation is darker. So this side definitely needs like more bronzing. Keep that in mind right now. That's not exactly against the product. It's just the shade issue. I don't know why. I always thought this was darker. I feel like it's been darker. For the sake of just showing, I'm gonna use the third step, which is the brighten part, and put it right here, which you can see. It's kind of like, it's almost like glittery in a way. I'm gonna put that right here, and I'm gonna add extra amount of this powder on this side in that area, because this is a one-step situation. And I feel like they do the same thing, they glow. For the sake of looking a little bit more even, I'm gonna use the Set the Stage powder from Collab in Beige Tan and just put it in this like cheek contour area and the sides of the forehead on both sides. So you guys can really look right now before I do so on the finish of the foundation on this side and then the finish of the foundation on this side. I just don't want us to look really, really, really crazy. This basically became our setting powder for the whole face. All right, I feel like that's a lot better. I know that probably irked some of you guys, but it is what it is. We're almost at the end of the video. We have lips. That's it. Lips. I'm gonna throw a little mascara on the lower lash line just so we don't feel like that whole area is just too bare. Like we're really heavy on the top right now, so let's try to even it out. Got a smudge. Going into both palettes, I'm gonna grab just a little bit of the warm brown that's in our crease and just place it right here. Very, very lightly, like barely there. As I say that, it's like super apparent, but there you go. Feels a little bit more complete. Just taking whatever blending brush we used earlier and just kind of connecting it in. There we go. So now we gotta work on these lips. They were hydrated, but it's been a little bit and I ate some lunch, so let's hope this works out. I found two amazing dupes in my lip drawer and I wanna show you guys both of them. The first one being a Collab dupe. This is using our Nude Addiction Dual Lip Color. So this has a matte color, like matte liquid lip on the bottom, a creamy one, and then we have a gloss on the top. I've worn this in many different shades. Very, very nice, really, really affordable. She's only $11 and it comes in a lot of shades. While the high-end side is another one of my favorites. This is by Patrick Ta Beauty. This is the Monochrome Moment in She's Confident. A really amazing formula, like amazing. I've seen it work wonders on my dry lips. The thing is, the finish is a little different, but the color looks really exact to me. This side will definitely be more matte because it's supposed to be matte. Well, this is more of a cream, in my opinion, that dries down to just be a little less glossy. So let's start with the drugstore side. Bring it on in, bring it on in. Take a look. We're not gonna use any liner today. And this is Peach Bellini. So the finishes are really similar until this one dries down. So we have a flat pad on this side. It's actually the applicator that we chose as a group that we really liked, and it definitely worked out for the formulation because you need different applicators depending on what you're using. So I'm gonna let her dry first so you guys can see the major difference. We do have a gloss as mentioned on this side, so with a little bit of the gloss, it kind of evens out in finish. This isn't fully dry yet, but I'm gonna start on the side. This has a teardrop applicator and more of like a moussey texture right away. Both of them are pretty creamy compared to liquidy, but I consider the Patrick Ta side a little bit more moussey. Now we're gonna give them both a second to dry. You can see I tried to make the line pretty prominent in the bottom lip so you can just really see the division. So again, it's not exact, but it's really similar. Let's add a little gloss. I personally prefer these duos with the gloss because then when the gloss fades down, it's still really beautiful and really hydrated. I did not gloss this side, so the finish is a little shiny on this side, but it is very, again, similar. I can say it a million times. I'm gonna do a quick blot. And then it looks really identical to me. Unfortunately, this side, I do have like a dry piece of skin. It's always on that side of my face, unfortunately. But the color, the coin saved. We love that. We love that for the new year. I just removed the combo to show you guys one more lip combo I found. I couldn't help it. I wanted to give you guys one, but I ended up with two. I'm sure you guys don't mind. The drugstore side is from NYX. Again, this is their Lingerie Push-Up Long-Lasting Lipstick. It's in like a pencil cream eyeshadow look to it. And this is in shade Push-Up. Yes, Lingerie Push-Up in Push-Up. That is correct. This retails for $9. While on this side, we have the Bite Beauty Lip Crayon in Amoretti. And this retails for $26. This saves you $15, guys, $15. So let's get into showing you. They have very similar finishes too. Yes, this is really giving you my lips, but better today in this entire video. Amoretti is more of a twist up from the top while the NYX one twists up from the bottom. Very, very similar. The NYX is a little bit more matte. Again, more matte on this side. Drugstore really likes good matte. While the Bite one is a little more creamy just by nature. I think on both of the lip combos, you can see that this side, again, with the finish difference, is just like half a click, a little bit more vibrant or a little bit more like deep in a way, but they look the same. Like you wouldn't be able to tell me that you think I'm wearing two different lipsticks unless you knew I was wearing two different lipsticks. And I don't think y'all could tell me otherwise. You could clock me on the streets. Both of these products have an amount of cooling to them. So the Bite feels kind of like cooling and almost a little minty when you first put it on, while the NYX stays like that the entire time. It's very, very like cooling and comforting for me. But if you wouldn't like that, then obviously don't go for that side, because if it's gonna bother you, like, I don't want it to. It's not really plumping or anything like that. And if I blot away the shine, just gently, they look the same. They really do. All right, headbands off. Money pieces are out. We're about to tuck them in a second though, because the headband kind of squished our hair a little bit. But this is our finished look. So $294 versus $91. What do you think? What y'all feeling? The brows are definitely different to me. The shade is very apparent. Even the fluffiness is very apparent. Usually this brow is naturally fluffier than this one. This is my good brow, so that says a lot. Otherwise, the slight sheen, because I'm literally trained to notice the difference here and maybe a little bit here, because there's like two different powders versus the same powder. That's just me being really, really critical. Otherwise, I think, girl, save it. I think that's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all of these dupes. I enjoyed doing this for you all. It's always nice seeing everything side by side and finding different, you know, combinations within my own makeup collection. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know which side you preferred down below. Shout outs to Collab Makeup for partnering with me on today's video and, you know, supporting the channel twice this month. I appreciate them a lot for keeping the lights on. It's gonna be keeping the lights on for a while. We need to keep these lights on. And, you know, these years have just been crazy. If you guys are interested and are not following me on Instagram yet, feel free to do so. I've been posting more reels, just saying. My recent uploads are going to be on the screen right now, as well as the subscribe button. So go ahead and click that if you haven't yet. Join the fam. A lot of you have been asking me if I'm going to be doing a Best of Beauty 2020. We really didn't have a lot of releases, so it's taking me a while to rack my brain on what I really think deserves to be in the video. But I do plan on doing one for you all. It'll just be towards the end of the month. So thank you for being patient and thank you for requesting it. I really appreciate you guys. It'll be coming soon. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you guys in a later video.